sunflower oil be used to make oil paint? That is the question that I'm going to try to answer in this video. I'm going to first go into my reasoning behind why this can be possible, and then do a little experiment to find out. So, my reasoning behind thinking why sunflower oil could be used in oil painting is its iodine value. Basically, for an oil to be suitable for painting with, it must be a drying oil. All oils can be categorized either as drying oils, semi-drying oils, and non-drying oils. You can tell if an oil is a drying oil by looking at its iodine values. Drying oils have iodine values higher than 130. Semi-drying oils lie between the values of 115 and 130, and non-drying oils have a value of less than 115. I have no idea how that works, but it's science, so I'm going to trust it. Here's a table I made showing different types of oils and their values. You can see a lot of common oils, such as coconut and olive oil, are immediately ruled out as they fall into the non-drying category. There's the semi-drying category, nothing special there, and then the most interesting category to me out of all of them are the oils that lie between semi-drying and fully drying oils. With ranges that fall pretty deep into the drying oil iodine value, I have not seen anything out there that would negate grapeseed oil and sunflower oil being used as oil paint mediums. Lastly are the drying oils. These contain the very popular and commonly used linseed oil, as well as hemp seed oil, which I was surprised to find out. Sunflower is very cheap and very available. If it can be used to allow art making to become cheaper and accessible, then that's a pretty great thing. If you're a painter, you already know that oils are not cheap and can only be found in certain stores, whereas sunflower oil is everywhere. This, coupled with making your own pigments, means a very sustainable practice and easy access to paint. This won't affect me too much, or many of you out there, but it could make a huge difference for people who are off-grid or people who can't afford to spend lots of money on art supplies. So, to test it out, I'm going to combine sunflower oil with a pigment of my choice and basically wait and see if it dries. The pigment I'm choosing for this is white clay that I have grinded and sifted. I chose it because it's extremely stable and shouldn't have an effect on the sunflower oil's chemistry and natural behavior. I placed some of the clay on my glass plate, added some sunflower oil, and mulled it with my palette knife. I mulled some of this same clay earlier with walnut alkyd so that I can compare the differences. I noticed that I put too much sunflower oil. I guess it's way more viscous than other oils, and that a little bit goes a very long way. It does have a very nice, oily, slippery consistency though, but it's far from buttery or dense. If this works, I would add much less oil the next time I use it. After mixing the oil and pigment, I painted them on a piece of primed canvas. I'm painting the sunflower oil mixture right next to the walnut alkyd again for easy comparison. Now for the fun of watching paint dry. I'm going to put this aside and check on it over the course of 7 weeks. If it's not dry by then, I will consider this a failure and give up on the dream of sunflower oil paint. Here is a check on week 5. I noticed that the sunflower oil is dry, but still is a little soft and malleable. I see that the swatch with the walnut alkyd is the same, so I give them another 2 weeks of drying just to be sure. After 2 weeks, I check again and the paint is no different. I can easily leave fingerprints and nail marks in it, which is a bad sign. I'm not sure why it's happening. Could it be the clay itself? There really is no difference between the sunflower oil and the walnut alkyd when it comes to how they've dried. The areas with thinner paint are completely dry though, and I don't see much sign of yellowing. Taking everything into consideration, I would have to answer the question with a yes. Sunflower oil could be used in oil painting. It definitely creates a film. However, how durable that film is still up for debate. But still, there is a reason to be optimistic about it. If you have any idea why the paint dried this way, please let me know in the comments below, as well as any other suggestions or questions. I hope you enjoyed this video and/or found it useful. There's more where that came from, and thanks for watching.